The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 13th chapter, text number 1 and 2, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on February 25th, 1975, in Miami, Florida.
Arjuna said, "My dear Krishna, oh my dear Krishna, I wish to know about Prakriti, nature, Purusha, the enjoyer, and the field and the knower of the field, and of knowledge and the end of knowledge." The Blessed Lord then said, "This body, O son of Kunti, is called the field, and one who knows this body is called the knower of the field."
Arjuna vacha prakritim purusham caiva cetram cetragam cetragam evacha etat veditum icchami jnanam gheyam chakesha. Sri Bhagavan vacha idam shariram kaunteya cetram iti avidhiyat etat jo vetti tam prahu cetragam iti tadvidah. So, Arjuna and Krishna, they are two friends, but friendly talking does not come to any conclusion. Therefore, Arjuna knew that Krishna, although he is my friend, he is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He knew it. Therefore, he selected him as his spiritual master. So we are not going to talk anymore as friends. Now I know that you can dissipate all my ignorance because you are the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So I accept you as my spiritual master. Shishastriham sadhimam karvanyam. I am now your shishya, disciple. Disciple means who voluntarily accepts the spiritual master to be regulated. Disciple means one who is regulated by higher authority. Higher authority is called the spiritual master, and the person who voluntarily submits to him for being regulated, he is called disciple. Everyone is very much papta. This is material condition. Even the most insignificant person, he thinks of himself as very important. Nobody wants to submit to anyone. This propensity is very prominent in this age, Kali Yuga. That word is called Kali Yuga, means this age. Why can I accept your proposition? I am also independent. I can think independently. This is the general propensity. But to understand the transcendental subject matter, one has to become submissive. That is the first qualification. Because the disease is that nobody is submissive. Nobody wants to be lower than anybody. Although he is insignificant, he has no value. But still, this is called Maya. He thinks himself to be very elevated, learned. So, our Krishna consciousness movement is teaching people to become submissive to the authority. That is the beginning of learning. Tadvidhi pranipatena pariprasnena sevaya. If you want to learn the transcendental subject matter, which is beyond the scope of your thinking, feeling and willing. Mental speculation means thinking, feeling and willing. Psychology. But subject matter which is beyond your thinking. So God or anything about God is beyond the limit of our thinking, speculation. Therefore, we have to learn it, submission. Sarvidhi panipasena. Panipas means submission. Pratishthe rupena nikah. Nikah means submission. Sarvidhi panipasena paripasena. First of all, find out somebody where you can fully surrender. Then you inquire about transcendental subject matter. Just like Arjuna is following strictly, he has first of all submitted to Krishna. Sishasthiham sadhivam drapannam. My dear Krishna, we are talking friendly. So, on equal level, so you will speak something and I shall speak something. In this way, we shall simply waste our time and there will be no conclusion. Therefore, I submit as desired. Whatever he will say, I will accept. This is the first condition. First of all, find out such person whom, upon whom you have full faith that whatever he will say, you will accept. That is good. If you think that you know better than your guru, then there is no use. First of all, you find out the person, that one who is better than you. Then you submit. Therefore the rules and regulations are that nobody should accept blindly any guru, and nobody should blindly accept any desire. They must behave one another at least for 1 year, so that the prospective disciple can also understand whether I can accept this person as my guru, and the prospective guru also can understand whether this person can become my disciple. This is the instruction by Sanatana Goswami in his Hari Bhakti Vilas. So, here Arjuna has accepted Krishna as his guru, and he submissively says that prakritim purusham chaiva. Prakriti means nature, and purusha means the exploiter of the nature. Just like we are in this material world, especially in the Western countries, they are very much fond of developing undeveloped countries. That means exploit. Or to become purusha, enjoy. You Americans, you came from Europe, and now you have developed the whole America, very nice cities, towns, and very well developed. That is called the exploiting the resources. So prakriti, nature, and we are living entities, especially the human being, they are purusha. But actually, we are not enjoyer. We are false enjoyer. We are not indigenous in this sense. Suppose you are Americans, you have developed this tract of land known as America very nicely. But you cannot enjoy. You are thinking that you are enjoying, but you cannot enjoy. After some time, you will be kicked out, get out. Then how you are enjoying? You may think that at least for 50 years, 100 years, I'm enjoying. So you can say that you can enjoy, so-called enjoy, but you cannot be permanent enjoy. That is not possible. Therefore, this land was, American land, was there before your time from Europe, your forefathers. And your forefathers have left. Mr. Washington, George Washington, he left, many others who developed this land of America. They have left here or there. And France, there was Napoleon Bonaparte, in Germany there was Kaiser, and in our country there was Gandhi or somebody else. So they come here, they falsely declare as enjoyer, but actually they are not enjoyer. They are kicked out. They come to enjoy the nature, but the nature kicks them out. This is the fact. So, then who is the enjoyer? The real enjoyer is Krishna, because he is controlling the prakriti and controlling you. We can very easily understand. Two things are there, matter and living entities, but none of them are independent. There is a controller. That controller, supreme controller, is God, Krishna. Therefore he is in there. And it is declared in the Bhagavad Gita, Bhoktaram Jagratavasam Sarvaloka Maheshwaram Sriram Sarvabhutanam Gyatya Amam Shanti Chit. Here we have taken the position of Purusha, falsely. We are trying to exploit the material nature for a few days, and in due course of time we will be asked by prakriti and natural laws, now sir, you have enjoyed me so much, now you get out. Then how you are Purusha? Purusha means enjoy. The Purusha becomes under the ruling of prakriti, then how is Purusha? He is not Purusha. Therefore in Bhagavad Gita, the living entity has been described as prakriti, not Purusha. Aparayam itastu vidhine prakritim para. So say, this is material nature, matter, dull matter, earth, water, air, fire, sky, these are called gross material elements. So, they are also prakriti. Bhinna prakriti me asada. Krishna says that these material elements, earth, water, fire, air, the sky, mind, intelligence and ego, eight. They are all material. Mind is also material. There is spiritual also, but whatever is within our experience, there is material. So, that is claimed as Krishna's prakriti or energy. Bhinna means, but they are separated energy. And Krishna says, next verse, aparayam. Apara means inferior. This is inferior nature. Itastu vidhine prakritim para. Beyond this, there is another prakriti, nature. That is para, superior. What is that para prakriti? The jiva bhuta, mahabahu, jayidam dhajate. So, that jiva bhuta, living entity, is also prakriti, but superior prakriti. In which way it is superior? Because the living entity are trying to exploit the dull material entity. So both of them are prakritis, but one is superior and one is inferior. That's why one may have more than one wife, one or two. The husband is one, and the wife may be two or more than two. But actually that is the position. The Supreme Lord is the husband or the Purusha. Husband means Purusha, and Prakriti means three. Three means woman. Male, female. The two things. The supreme male is Krishna. And everyone, either the dull matter or the living entity, they are called female, Prakriti. Prakriti means female. And Purusha means male. So nobody is actually male except Krishna. We are also female. We are dressed like male, and somebody is dressed like female. But all of us, we are female, prakriti, enjoyable. The enjoyer is Krishna. That we do not know. Here, the so-called woman is also Purusha, because she is also trying to enjoy. Anyone who is trying to enjoy, he is called to be Purusha. And the subject matter or object, object which is enjoyed, that is called Prakriti. So, in the material world, we are trying to exploit one another, either in the dress of male or in the dress of female, because this body is dressed. So, originally we are all female, but falsely you are trying to enjoy one another or this material world. Therefore they are sometimes called Purusha. So this question is raised by Arjuna from his master, because the master is accepted to acquire knowledge. Tadvijnanartham sa guru meva vivacche. To accept one guru is not a fashion. Nowadays it has become a fashion to accept some guru, Guru Maharaj. Whether he knows or does not know, it doesn't matter. Whether one is inquisitive or not. Is it fashion? No. Guru is required for a person who is very inquisitive to know about the transcendental subject matter. Tasmād gurum prapadveta jigyāsu sreya uttamam. It is not fashion, it is necessary. Because human life is meant for understanding the real position of his identity. Athātum brahma jidvāsa. This is necessary. The modern civilization is suffering from this defect that they are not implicitly about the Brahma, they are simply just like cats and dogs. They are interested in this body and the bodily necessities of life. They do not know beyond that. That is the difference. The other day in Caracas, some psychiatrists came. Their question was that the problems of the world are increasing. So, what is your prescription to solve these problems? So, the problem is very easy to be solved. I gave the example that this body is there, and there is something which is moving the body, living force. So that living force is the driver of the body, and the body is also described in the Bhagavad Gita as a machine. It is actually, it is a machine. Ishvara sarva-bhutanam vidyeshe arjuna tisthati brahmayam sarva-bhutani jantra-rurhani maya. Jantra means machine. So, we are seated on this machine. This is the knowledge. The person who is seated in the car or the machine, nobody knows. There are so many advancements of knowledge, department. But where is the department to understand that the living force which is driving this machine, what is that living force? How it is working? There is no inquiry and no education. Therefore, this education has no value. They do not know what is education. Education means to inquire about the living force which is moving this body. That is education. This is not education, that we have manufactured nice car, a nice machine. That is called craftsmanship. That is not education. Just like one electrician, he knows how to join the two wires and bring current. In India it is called mistri. Mistri means worker. Because he knows the technical art, how to bring electric current, that does not mean he is educated. Education is given. The worker does working so many wonderfully. But that does not mean they are educated. That is, in Sanskrit it is called the English is craftsmanship. He knows the art, how to do it. So at the present moment the technical education is there. Formerly this technical education was entrusted to the demons. Formerly they are also manufacturing big aeroplanes, but they are being done by the demons, not by the great saintly person sages, no. They are being done by the demons. And the yogis, they could produce such wonderful things by their yogic mystic power. That was another. But generally, when there is a question of manufacturing, that was being done by the demons. So, actually, at the present moment, although we are manufacturing so many nice things for the comforts of the body, but that does not mean it is education. Education means Brahma Vidya, to understand what is that living force within this body that is working. What is its position, constitution, position, how it is working, where from it has come, so many things. That is called Brahma Jignasa. To inquire about the spirit, that is education. So that education is lacking, therefore there are so many problems at the present moment. The problems are created. It's like if I do not give food to the driver and is entrusted with a nice car, and he is not happy on account of not being properly taken care of, then he must create disaster. They are in a car accident. So that is happening. Nobody is taking care of the driver of this body. No education is there. They are simply trying to rectify the defects in the body. That is inquired here. Khetra, khetra, khetra gancha. This body is khetra, field of activities. But the field worker is divine. Therefore this is inquired. Khetram, khetram. We are taking care of this khetra, this body, but we do not take care of the occupier of the body or the owner of the body. There are two khetra you will find in this verse. Two living entities. One is called the soul, and the other is called the super soul. In this body there are two souls. One is the occupier soul and the other is the proprietor soul. Proprietor soul, that's like in a house, there are two kinds of person, the occupier and the landlord. The landlord is actually the proprietor of the house, and the tenant is occupier. Similarly, there are two souls within this body. That is stated in the Vedic literature, just like two birds on one tree. So the living entity, the individual soul, is there. He is also one bird. And the super soul or God is also there. So God, the super soul, is simply observing the activities of the individual soul. And he has given freedom to the individual soul, because the individual soul has come in this material world to enjoy, independent of the super soul. That is the material disease. He has to remain under the protection. He is already under the protection of the super soul, but he is thinking that he is independent. That is called Maya. He is not independent. As soon as there is call of death, he is no more independent. He cannot say that I have got so many business to do, but perform, give me some time. No, immediately, get out. So he is under control, fully control. Still he is thinking that he is independent and he can do whatever he likes. In this way, his life is being spoiled. And he is becoming entangled by the activities. And there is strong, stringent laws of nature, exactly karanam gunasangasya sadasat janma jonishu. These things are all explained in Bhagavad Gita. Why one is put into one type of body and why one is put into another type of body? One body is enjoying very nicely. Not enjoying, he is also suffering. He is enjoying for a limited time. he is also suffering, but he comparatively, one is situated in a very nice comfortable position and the other is not. The father is envious, why this man is in a comfortable situation and I am put into, so let us become communist, a revolt against this person or this group of persons. In this way, the struggle for existence is going on and there is no solution. How there can be solution? Because they are all analytic, not educated. So if you want to be educated, make the solution of all the problems of the world, then we must take to this Krishna consciousness. This is the only solution. It will educate people, the real identity, real position, and as Arjuna is trying to understand what is prakriti, what is purusha, what is khetarga, what is knowledge, what is noble. These questions are posed, gradually we shall discuss. That is one thing. In ignorance, if we fight, there is no solution. In darkness, if we fight, we may wound you, I may wound you, you may wound me, but there is no solution. So those whole world is in darkness. Therefore there is struggle. One is capitalist, one is communist, one is this, one is that, and there is struggle. Because everyone is in ignorance. Maya andhaka, in darkness of ignorance. And Krishna is light. Ignorance, fighting, will not make any solution of the problem. We must come to the light and take knowledge from the most enlightened Krishna, Bhagavan. Bhagavan means he is endowed with six kind of opulence. He is the supreme rich, he is the supreme famous, the supreme beauty, and supreme wise. We have to take knowledge from the supreme wise. That is not, that knowledge is perfect. Therefore here it is said, Bhagavan was. I did not say Krishna, Vasudeva does not say Krishna, because Krishna may be taken by the demons as something like us. Therefore he purposefully says Bhagavan. Bhagavan was means the Supreme Personality of God. There cannot be any doubt about his knowledge. Bhagavan Vacha, whatever Bhagavan says, that is fact. That is not knowledge like that. It may be, perhaps, these are all aspects. It may be, perhaps, that is not knowledge. That is speculation. Speculation is different, and knowledge is different. You cannot speculate about the absolute knowledge, because our senses are imperfect. How can speculator come to the right conclusion? That is not possible. You must receive direct knowledge. This is this. Therefore it is said, Bhagavan Vacha. So whatever Bhagavan will speak, that is absolute knowledge. And if we take it, then we shall be perfect. I may be perfect, you may be, I may be imperfect, you may be imperfect. But when we take knowledge from the perfect, that knowledge is absolute. So, voluntarily, we should try to accept the knowledge and instruction given by Krishna, then our life will be perfect. Thank you very much.